We've all seen this picture 1,000 times before. A toxic haze enveloping whole cities as smoke is relentlessly spewed from power plants upwind. Chinese people wearing face masks, venturing out from the safety of their homes into the busy, polluted streets, despite the health warnings flashing across their screens, advising them to do the exact opposite. Yes, we have all seen this picture before. It is the picture used to tell us that China has a pollution problem. A problem so much more acute and intense compared to any other place on Earth. This is of course true, but it isn't the whole story. As China is one of the most aggressive investors in renewable energy solutions, as well as developing strict policies that are pushing whole industries into the clean technology paradigm. China has used their industrial strength to grow into a superpower, but this has come at a cost. While income levels have risen and lifted people out of poverty, tremendous amounts of waste, pollution, and environmental harm has been created at the same time. China has a pollution problem, partly because the world has a consumption problem. But just as quickly as China has risen economically, they are now providing global leadership towards a low-carbon, circular economy. Wind turbines and vast solar arrays can be seen everywhere in China today. China has 70% of installed solar thermal capacity in the world. They are the world's largest producer of solar PV, as well as being the globe's leading installer. In cities like Beijing and Shanghai, laws have changed so that transportation is increasingly powered by electric vehicles of all shapes and sizes. But there is another way to address this problem of pollution that is being met head-on by a Nordic clean technology company operating in China.
Everything you see around you is made by using compressed air, and that counts for 5% of the world's electricity use.
Christian Merheim is the executive chairman of Enersize, a Nordic clean technology company that is using the Internet of Things and advanced computer analytics to focus on a relatively unknown user of the world's electricity, compressed air systems. Vast amounts of energy is used to compress air so that it can be used to make our stuff. But these systems are terribly inefficient for a number of reasons. Degradation of the system over time, bottlenecks appearing in the system due to changes in production needs and poor design, and inefficiency of operation and management of these due to a lack of insight. These compressed air systems draw on energy from the local Chinese grid to be put to work in manufacturing, accounting for almost 10% of total electricity use in China. Reducing pollution and making factories more efficient in China are the driving forces behind the work of Christian Merheim and the rest of the team at Enersize. They have been steadily increasing the number of factories that are using Enersize technology, and they are here just outside of Shanghai today to meet up with a potential new customer.
My name is Christian Merheim. I'm the executive chairman of Enersize, and what we want to do with Enersize is to become the world leader in making software for making compressed air systems work efficient. And efficient is not only energy efficient, it's also making the compressed air system work optimal. You don't want to have the compressed air system cause production stop. So what we do is that we put sensors in the whole system, measuring the system, and then have advanced computer and expert analyze it. And we see where the small problems are or what parameters can be set at a better level.
With 90% of manufacturing worldwide using compressed air, the more customers that Enersize can bring into their software, the greater the environmental impact. Something that one of the major investors in Enersize, Cleantech Invest, is particularly excited about. Alexander Lidgren is the CEO of Cleantech Invest, and he's been helping Enersize increase their impact over a number of years.
It's been great watching Enersize grow over the last few years. we've added both Sami and Christian to the team over those years, and I think both have been catalysts for taking the company to the next level. One of the more inspiring things about being an owner in Enersize is the carbon effect they're having. One of their recent customers alone use as much electricity as a small village here in Sweden. So there really is a huge carbon effect by installing these things in China as opposed to here in the Nordics. One of the other success factors, I think, for Enersize has been that they've been able to work with some really good partners in China. And I think that's crucial if you want to succeed on that market. In Joint Team and in Daniel Chu, they have had really good partners. And that is crucial for success there, I think.
Daniel Zhu is one of these Chinese partners, located in the Shanghai region, who is helping Enersize access customers and increase the efficiency of Chinese manufacturing.
Actually, China so far is engaging, from the pressure of the central government to do more efficiently on energy consumption or energy saving. And the government is pushing hard. Plus, company has a high motivation to save energy. By looking at the fooling technology, Enersize technology is one of the best technology that can give them comprehensive solution for energy saving.
Zeona Holmberg is also an Enersize team member who provides a bridge between the Nordics and China, and she sees tremendous opportunities for Enersize in this massive market.
I joined Enersize in the beginning of 2011, and I was with Enersize management group together exploring and developing Chinese market. And also this manufacturing industry is now in an updating period to be more smart, intelligent. This is really the trend, and this is what Enersize is now doing. So I believe, especially compressed air, it's such widely used in different kind of manufacturing companies. 90% of all kinds of manufacturing companies. So altogether, it's a huge potential for us.
Joint Team in Beijing were one of the first partners to work with Enersize in the Chinese market. Understanding the need for energy efficiency in Chinese manufacturing being one of the many reasons for helping Enersize grow in this market.
这个中国的这个绿色制造呢，是我们国家 2025包括未来的几十年的发展规划当中很重要的一步。Enersize的技术呢是非常有特点的，第一呢是在工业领域是系统性的节能，而不是单个的某一项的，所以这是现在的工厂呢都是需要的。另外一个呢，它是用了互联网加，是用大数据。 对工厂的用能系统呢进行分析、诊断，然后找出呢节能空间。
Joint Team was also critical in finding one of the early customers for Enersize in China, Beijing Optoelectronics, who are very happy with the impact Enersize is having for them.
京东方的空压系统呢，年耗电量比较大，每年整体的耗电量大概在4000到5000万左右啊。就使用了 Enersize 这个系统以后啊，15年啊已经。 一年的节省，用电量呢，大概在5590万度电左右啊。
With its unique technology and use of advanced computer analytics, Enersize is here to be a leader in this field. They are today improving their technology using machine learning and artificial intelligence. Their mission is to have Enersize technology installed in every factory on the planet. Healthier cities, communities, ecosystems. They all demand that we become more efficient with the energy we use. Wasting it is no longer acceptable. Maybe global manufacturing can become much cleaner, faster, with this Nordic technology in the driver's seat.